The people have a right to know. I'm Scott Ott, and this is Bill Whittle Now. And Bill, the chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, Gerald Nadler, the Democrat from, I believe, New York, is part of a group of Democrats who have just subpoenaed the official report of the Mueller investigation. Now, as those of us who have been paying attention to this know, the Attorney General already released a brief summary of that investigation, which said that there was no collusion between President Trump or his campaign and Russia in the 2016 election process. And the Attorney General has also said he plans to release most of the report within the month of April, redacted only for security purposes and to protect executive privilege. However, the House Judiciary Committee thinks the people have a right to know. And Bill, with the lover of liberty that you are, I can't imagine you're going to stand in the way of that, are you?
No, why would I do that? I think that absolutely should be made public, and as long as the appropriate security redacted occurrences take place, I think it should be released to the public. I think this is a gigantic case of rope-a-dope. I don't see anybody who thinks in this day and age that you could have a report that contains legally actionable information or evidence and then pretend like it's not there and say, no, there was nothing in it. So, to the degree that the longer they want to thrash this dead horse, the further behind they're going to get. And that's what this sounds like to me. I'm sure the Judiciary Committee would like to see the report because they will, as we pointed out in one of our episodes, discover that, that Donald Trump didn't extend a pinky finger on a high-level meeting with a British diplomat during tea service or whatever the case may be. But I have no reason to worry about what's in that report after the fact that not only did the Attorney General say there's nothing in there, Nancy Pelosi said there's nothing in there, too. And
not directly.
Well, let's face nobody says anything directly in politics, Scott. For the leader of the opposition party who's got 80% of her constituency clamoring for blood, for her to say let's wait and see is one thing. For her to say there may or may not be enough evidence is one thing. But for her to say, on reflection, he's just not really worth impeaching is to say that there's nothing there.
Well, you've expressed concern before that if the full report were released, that there would be a lot of information gathered in the course of investigation that is perhaps not actionable, but still may cause trouble for the individuals involved, not just for President Trump and his campaign, but also for the wide network of witnesses who testified. A Republican from Colorado named Ken Buck actually tried to amend the House Judiciary Committee motion by suggesting that at least grand jury testimony should be excluded from that subpoena, and his amendment failed on a party line vote. What do you think of just kind of opening Pandora's box of everything that the very inquisitive Mueller and his team may have discovered?
Well, you have an issue of national security that is a legitimate issue in terms of withholding information. And you also have, I think, a moral obligation to honor promises to people who may have given you, I'm not talking about anonymous testimony now, I'm talking about testimony that may have been given in exchange for anonymity. That's not the same as like citing anonymous sources. I think those people need to be protected. I agree with your statement. I think the American people have a right to know just about everything that goes on in the government. And the thing I find especially delicious about this is that I don't think that if it were me, and I was Nancy Pelosi or Chuck Schumer or any one of the leading Democrats in this country, that full transparency would be a subject that I would want to ride a horse on. But if they want to, that's fine with me. In fact, I think that would be grand. I think it's another opportunity for a splendid counterattack. If it turns out that this report is as baseless as it appears to be, then I say Donald Trump should basically say, hey, no, by all means, here's the whole report. We pulled the security the security issues out of it to protect our intelligence sources. Yeah, here's the whole thing. And when they find out that they've got nothing other than perhaps some evidence of boorishness or rudeness, you can only imagine the shock that will descend on the nation. And the giant wheels of impeachment will stay as frozen as they are basically right now. But if Donald Trump wants to go along that road and say, okay, you want full disclosure, here's full disclosure. Now let's have a look at everything that's in the Hillary Clinton folder. Let's have a look at everything, you know, pertaining to the Benghazi thing. Let's have a look at where Barack Obama was on that night and what he was doing. Let's have a look at all of this stuff. Transparency is not just something that's useful to conservatives when it's something to jab progressives with, and then something that we should be against when it may conceivably be bad for conservatives. Transparency in government is the entire idea that the government works for us and not the other way around. And as far as I'm concerned, we not only have a right to see everything that the government does, we have a moral obligation to see it. There are reasonable restrictions on some information that pose a national security risk to this country.
Well, it goes beyond that, though, Bill, because Representative Doug Collins from Georgia, he's a Republican as well, points out to the committee, and he's part of this committee, he points out to Chairman Nadler that the five witnesses that they've also said must come and testify before this committee have already been cooperating. There was no need to demand their cooperation, and that if they were to say that the Attorney General must turn over grand jury transcripts, for example, they would be commanding that the Attorney General actually violate the law because those grand jury testimonies are supposed to be secret.
Obviously, that is not something that should happen. And again, Scott, I don't know how long, you know, watching progressives and leading Democrats with this Mueller report. It's like watching the captain of the Titanic grabbing on to the red white star pennant on the back end of the ship as it plummets down to the bottom. And the belief that somehow if I grab that flag and tread water hard enough, I'll stop the Titanic from going to the bottom. That's what it's starting to feel like to me, is that they simply cannot emotionally accept the fact that this thing that was fabricated out of thin air is in fact thin air, and that they are going to try and milk every single possible drop of nothingness out of this nothing burger, and seem to think that if we spend another year, you know, percolating and squeezing and filtering and brewing, we might be able to get a drop or two more of general unpleasantness about Donald Trump, and this is going to be a victory for them. If they're married to this illusion, that's just great with me. I think that the fact that the probe vindicated Trump is when they should have the sense to cut their losses and get off of this losing proposition. But if they want to stay on it, I think that's just grand. I think it's grand for the president. I think it's grand for 2020 prospects. I think it shows that there is not only not anything there in terms of evidence against Donald Trump, but there is, in fact, an ongoing effort in the government to manufacture charges against a duly elected president in order to change the results of the election that they simply cannot accept. And the more of this that we see, the more of this that the American public sees, the more convinced they will become, as I've become convinced, and most people have become convinced who are supporters of Donald Trump, maybe weren't as avid supporters, you know, prior to the election and immediately afterwards. Every day that goes by gives me more and more reason to support this president despite his faults, because it gives me more and more evidence to see that first of all of the charges leveled against him so far are baseless, and secondly, that this is in fact a slow motion coup, and it's been put in place It probably got put in place in the two or three days it took Hillary Clinton to sober up. This is what it is. It's as I said in the firewall, the mission of the Mueller report was not to find anything on Donald Trump. The mission, because they knew that in the beginning, they are the ones that launched the investigation based on no evidence. The mission of the Mueller report was to delegitimize Donald Trump, and more importantly, to delegitimize the American people and their decision in 2016. And to the degree that it has basically been a cloud over the president's first 2.5 years, it's been very, very successful. Now they'll continue to do the other parts of the job that they need to do to make sure that the American people never again get up on their hind legs and decide to determine their own future. And some of the things that we're going to be seeing are major, major attempts to abolish the Electoral College. which is a very, very delicate, clever, in fact, ingenious invention designed to spread power among these states and make sure that the urban populations don't continue to rule the rest of the country for the rest of time. If you look at it, it is absolutely fair that every single person should get one vote. That's certainly not what the progressives are working on, but let's just take it as a theory. And it's absolutely true that in large population areas, you have more votes than you do otherwise in rural areas. But if you look at the map of the United States by county, not by state, you look at the United States by county, and you see a blood red country with blue ink drops around the population centers. And to say that the people living inside those blue ink drops, which coincidentally happen to be areas where the crime is by far the greatest and all the other unpleasantness in the country, all of the pathologies are pretty much right in the middle. If you take an area, if you were to take the Democratic results for the 2016 election and superimpose them over a map of where the highest amounts of crime, drug abuse, and all this other stuff goes, you're gonna find a very tight correlation there. To say that those people in these cities, in Chicago and places like that, are going to rule the entire country because they can pull together more votes in that particular area is not how this country is designed. The country never would have been formed if that were the case. And to say that this is going to be the case is pretty good basis for me to say, if that's what's going to happen, then unform the country.
Well, the White House has already indicated that it will be reluctant to have the Attorney General turn over these kind of documents, as the Attorney General has already indicated that he will report in a redacted way to Congress. We will see what happens here, because we're reporting 5 days a week here on Bill Whittle Now, thanks to the members at BillWhittle.com who fund the creation and distribution of this program. Actually, 20 episodes of this program every month, another 24 programs of a different name, and a whole member blog that's on our new BillWhittle.com website. So if you'd like to be part of Team Liberty and enjoy those things at our website, we invite you to become a member today at BillWhittle.com. So for Bill Whittle, I'm Scott Ott. Thanks to the members for making it happen.